How do you know your marketing efforts actually do their thing? That's quite the question. Everybody knows the chatbot is a must-have on a website, but what happens after you install it? Just like a car needs regular maintenance for the safest rides, so does a chatbot for the best results. Let's run through the core metrics you must track if you care about your chatbot's well-being. Hi there and welcome, my name is Anya and you are watching the SendPulse channel. Here my colleagues and I store the most effective and essential marketing tips and guides. And today we are talking about chatbots. Again. But no worries, now are now tips on how to market through chatbots. I am sick and tired of those, to be honest. Hear this. As of 2021, the global chatbot market reached a value of $3.7 billion. And you know what? By 2027, the market will skyrocket to $13.9 billion. Doing the math now, aren't you? This is a drastic jump for sure, almost by 25%. So if you're still using a chatbot to answer the FAQs, well, think again. Apart from being available 24/7 and being cost-effective, chatbots can shed some light on your business performance. Of course, I don't mean that your chatbot is the holy grail of your marketing tools, but all of them, little by little, contribute to a company's success. Or fails? Since we are talking about chatbots today, let's skim through why you should keep an eye on their performance. Here are the takeaway benefits of checking in with your chatbot. You can focus on the right metrics. Once you know what your chatbot does for your business, you know how to check whether it does or doesn't do its job. You evaluate your chatbot's effectiveness. Chatbots help identify how your customers perceive chatbots, if they are satisfied with their responses, or if it's helping users to direct towards taking certain actions. You understand the customer journey. A chatbot sheds light on what questions users try to answer through your chatbot, while studying your brand, while choosing between your products, and so on. You measure ROI on business. Chatbot analytics helps to measure the KPIs such as total leads generated, total issues resolved, cost per issue, so that you can compare its performance with other channels. How exactly can you measure your chatbot performance? Some analysis wouldn't hurt. You can go to your chatbot settings to see the stats. But what do they all mean? That's where it's at. You might refresh memories of your marketing and business goals. What were you aiming at when starting a chatbot? Right, having goal rules. You can't have a chatbot just because it's a must-have tool. First, decide why you introduced this or that tool. To boost conversions, to improve customer experience, to automate communication, or to send marketing campaigns. This all should be decided beforehand, right to the last detail. There are a ton of metrics and we want to be done ASAP. So let's break down the most important evaluation metrics through three categories: user metrics, customer satisfaction metrics, and conversation metrics. Leaping ahead, SendPulse provide a ground for in-depth analysis of your chatbot performance. This means you can both create a code-free chatbot using SendPulse and receive a view of the most important performance data. Try SendPulse for free today. User metrics. So what do we have here? These are all crucial ways to check whether your audience actually has meaningful conversations with your bot. Total number of users helps you to capture insights on how many customers are using your chatbot. Engaged users are active users who have repeated the conversation with your bot on a daily or weekly basis. Number of new users is a great metric to estimate the success of promo campaigns and the bot's popularity. Chat volume measures the number of successful interactions made. Track how often your bot is used and whether your audience is increasing. Bounce rate refers to the number of users who enter your website and leave without interacting with your bot. The next metric group is conversation metrics. Conversation duration. There is no correct digit to provide. I'd say perfect conversation should last a certain number of steps to solve the user's problem. Short chats indicate that some bot flow is down and needs to be revised. Fallback rate captures insights about those scenarios where the bot is unable to understand the user request and provide a relevant solution. The higher the fallback rate, the lower the user satisfaction. This will give you insights on how to perfect flows in your bot. Interaction rate allows you to measure the average number of messages exchanged during the user bot conversation, long for a high interaction rate. And last but not least is customer satisfaction rate. Not much to mention here, just two points. Retention rate helps to record the percentage of users who return to interact with a chatbot within a specific period of time, return the visitors by delivering highly personalized content or offering a discount. And the second one is satisfaction score. This metric helps estimate users' experience of using your bot. Simply ask a yes or no question about users' experience upon the conversation with a bot. So as you see, your chatbot can give you so much info on your chatbot success. Choose the right chatbot metrics to evaluate its performance, identify the loopholes, and track its overall effectiveness. Let me know which metrics you find the most important in the comment section. Bye for now. Take care.